faire à manger. And we'll concentrate on les adjectifs. OK? So let's see now. Griller. Griller. Mariner. Mariner. Macérer. Macérer. En sauce. En sauce. Farci. Farci. En purée. En purée. Cuit. Cuit. Bouilli. Bouilli. Poché. Poché. Sauter. Sauter. Frit. Frit. Cuit à la vapeur. Cuit à la vapeur. Fumer. Fumer. Sécher. Sécher. Pluriel des noms composés. Because it's actually quite tricky for persons who are learning French, and even for French people, in some cases it can be quite tricky to put, when we call this nom composé, of course we call about a noun, but it's composed, so normally you get two parts. And when you want to put this noun at the plural form, then it can be a bit tricky. This video will only focus on the nouns that are formed by two nouns, okay? So we're not talking about adjectives or verbs or preposition, because it's possible. In that case, we're only concentrating on these nouns composed by two nouns, okay? And, well, the thing is that, as always in French, it's never 100%, because that's the way it works. But then the good news is that it's 90%, and it's quite much, in 90% of the cases, the two nouns will actually be at the plural form. Okay, so if you want to put this noun at the plural form, you will have to put the two nouns that compose this composed noun at the plural. Okay, I hope I'm clear. So I've been preparing few examples, okay? And here you've got the well singular form, le singulier. The first one, un homme grenouille, okay? So I will put here that translation in English, okay? Un homme grenouille. And so, well, as I said, if you want to put this noun at the plural form, then you will get des hommes here, so the S, mark of the plural, and then here as well, mark of the plural, grenouille. Okay, so un homme grenouille, des hommes grenouilles. Un homme orchestre, and so you get the translation here. Same thing, des hommes orchestre. Okay, so you get the plural here, and then the plural here. Okay. Un homme sandwich, and then you will get des hommes sandwich, like that as well. Une infirmière chef will give you des infirmières chef. Okay, and then you can notice that, well, as we saw previously, this final S is not pronounced, so clearly if you only think about, I mean, the phonetical aspect of the thing, une infirmière chef des infirmières-chefs. The only difference will be here in the liaison, because actually you don't pronounce this final S here or here. Okay, so une infirmière-chef, des infirmières-chefs. Un aide-comptable, des aides-comptables. Okay, same thing, you put this S and S here, but then you don't pronounce them. Un aide-cuisinier, des aides-cuisiniers. Okay, S and S. Un aide-infirmier, des aides-infirmiers. Un avion cargo, des avions cargo. Same thing, S, S, but then we don't pronounce them. Un avocat conseil, des avocats conseil. S, S, but then we don't pronounce it, or them. Un café concert, des cafés concerts. Un café-théâtre, des cafés-théâtres. Le pluriel des noms composés, ok, so if you didn't watch the first part, well, I would advise you to do it, ok, so it's, maybe it would be more clear. Ok, if you did, then let's start. And then keep in mind that this video, in this video we'll work or we'll see the words that will be composed by a noun and an adjective. Okay, so in the previous lesson we saw, well, these nouns, when they were composed by two nouns, okay, but in that case it will be noun and adjective. Okay, and then, well, it will be exactly the same thing. It's never 100% in French, so it will be 90%. So in 90% of the cases, you will have to put, well, the noun and the adjective at the plural form if you want to, well, put this all noun, so this composed noun at the plural form. Okay, so we'll see how it works. And then we'll have first the singular form here. So here is the first one, un haut commissionnaire. Okay, un haut commissionnaire. And if we want to put this word at the plural form, then it will be quite simple because you just need to here and here add the plural form. So in that case, it's S and S. Okay, des hauts commissionnaires. And if you're a bit careful, you can hear that un haut commissionnaire and des hauts commissionnaires, well, clearly it is pronounced the same way. So you put the S at the end of both things here, okay, but then you don't pronounce them. So it will be phonetically almost the same, okay, in most of the cases. Un haut relief, okay, un haut relief. And if we want to put the plural form, then it's quite simple because S and S, but then we don't pronounce them here. Des hauts reliefs. Okay? Un haut relief, des hauts reliefs. Un franc-maçon. Okay? Un franc-maçon. And then plural form, exactly the same rule. S here and S here. Des francs-maçons. And then you don't pronounce them. Des francs-maçons. Un franc-tireur. Un franc-tireur, and then plural form, exactly the same rule, des francs-tireurs. Un courbouillon, un courbouillon, and then if you want to put the plural form, well, same rule, S, S, you don't pronounce it, des courbouillons. Un courbouillon, des courbouillons. Un court-circuit, un court-circuit. Same thing, des courts-circuits, des courts-circuits. Un beau-père, un beau-père. So here it's interesting because if you remember, we saw that previously, this beau, so the adjective beau, you've got the singular form here, and you've got the plural here. You don't put S at the end for the plural, but you will put this X. Okay, so X à la fin de beau. Okay, but then it's exactly the same thing because you don't pronounce it. Des beaux pères. Okay, remember the S, but then it's silent. Des beaux pères. Un beau père, des beaux pères. Une belle mère, des belles mères. Same rule here, S and S, but you don't pronounce it. Une belle sœur, des belles sœurs. Okay? Une belle sœur, des belles sœurs. That's le pluriel des noms composés. And we'll take the time in this video to see something quite tricky. And I'm really sorry about that, but well, I need to do my job and to explain or to tell you how it goes. When you get this composed noun, and when this composed noun is composed by first a noun, or not first, but then a noun and the adjective grand, because in most of the cases this grand will be in the first place. Okay, it will be tricky. It will be tricky. Let's be honest. The thing is that we will need to divide this video and to see how it works for the masculine form and then the feminine form. Just because when we'll see the masculine form, it's actually quite easy. It is not difficult at all, because when we've got this example like un grand-père, okay, so of course you've got first this grand, and then after that you've got the père. If you want to put this word at the plural form, then you will get des grands-pères. And it's actually quite simple, because it will respect the rule, I mean the thing that we saw previously. You just need to put S at the end of each words, okay, so grand with S and then père with S, like that. Okay, so it's not really difficult, and especially if you think about that, you don't pronounce this S, so actually phonetically it's the same, grand-père here and grand-père here. Okay, so let's be honest, I mean, if it's for the masculine form, then it's not difficult, but if it's for the feminine form, and that's where it is a bit strange, but I mean that's just a language, so we need to see how it goes. If you have at the singular form for the feminine this form here, so grand instead of grande, because normally it's an adjective and normally we should have a here, okay, but it does happen that in some cases, like with this word in grand-mère, then actually you don't have this at the end of the adjective. So if you have this form, so first the adjective grand at the feminine, but not really at the feminine because you don't have this okay, then that's when it will be tricky, because you will have, well, two options to put the plural form. The first one will be this one, so you just put this S and S at the end of the first and the second part, okay? And it's also possible to see it like that, so only S at the end of the second word or the second part of this composed word, okay? So, des grand-mères. As I said, phonetically it's the same anyway, because it will be une grand-mère, des grand-mères, and then des grand-mères, okay, so phonetically the same form, but you've got to keep in mind that, you know, this is how it should be written correctly. And in that case, keep in mind that the two options are, correct, okay? So that's the first part. And it's also possible to see composed words or nouns with first the adjective grand, but at the feminine form, like here, with grande, okay, and then duchesse. And in that case, well, not really difficult, because you just, you know, do what we've been doing so far. So you just put S at the end of the first part and S at the end of the second part, okay, and you will get une grande duchesse, plural, des grandes duchesses. Le pluriel des noms composés, okay, and we'll see actually three different type of noms composés in this video, Okay, so we'll start with the first one. And the first one, actually, it will be un nom composé. So the first part will be un nom. Then the second part will be une préposition. And the last part will be un complément. Okay, so we'll, don't worry, we'll see an example. And in that case, well, in like 90% of the cases, the rule will be that it will be only le premier nom that will take the mark of the plural. Okay, so we'll see just one example. Un arc-en-ciel. Okay, so it's actually quite interesting. So the meaning is here, rainbow. And if you have a look, so you've got first arc, and then you've got the préposition, and after that you've got le complément ciel. Okay, and so if we respect the rule that we saw previously, it's only the first part here, so le nom arc, that will take the mark of the plural, and then it will be s. Okay, so you will have un arc-en-ciel, and then the plural form, des arc-en-ciel. Okay, you can see that as usual, we don't really pronounce this final S, so phonetically it's almost the same, but then we've got this liaison between the two, des arc-en-ciel. Okay, second situation, un nom formé d'une préposition or un préfixe et d'un nom. Okay, and so in that case, le nom prend la marque du pluriel. Okay, so we'll see an example. And it's a good example and quite useful here. Une demi-heure. Okay, so demi is half and then heure, hour. Okay, so in that case, you get this demi first and then you get this heure. Okay, and so if we respect the rule that we saw, it will be only le nom, like here, so heure, that will take here the plural. So you will have to put the S at the end of heure, and you don't touch this prefix demi in that case. Okay, des demi-heures. Une demi-heure, des demi-heures. Okay? And last but not least, un nom formé d'une phrase, locution adverbiale, de verbe ou d'infinitif. Okay? And in that case, the good thing is that you don't need to touch the word at all. Okay, so it will stay the same whether it's at the singular form or at the plural. And then just wanted to give you this beautiful one. It's one of my favorite, un je ne sais quoi. Okay, well, it's quite used in English as well, but then I just wanted to give you maybe a more clear translation. Okay, so un je ne sais quoi, and then if we respect the rule, then des je ne sais quoi. So you don't touch at all the word, you just put it like that, no S. Okay, and then phonetically, of course, it's the same pronunciation. Okay, un je ne sais quoi, des je ne sais quoi. Le E, so we're talking about letter, muet, okay, it does mean mute. Okay, well, clearly, when you won't have to pronounce this vowel, d'accord? So let's start, and we'll see actually four different situations when you shouldn't pronounce this letter, and let's see with the first one. Okay, so the first one, and the rule is quite clear, it's à la fin d'un mot, at the end of a word, then you shouldn't pronounce this like here, une voiture. Okay, so clearly here this will open, I mean the sound, so it's you won't have to pronounce it like une nasale, un, but then it's une. Okay, but then you don't insist on it, so clearly you don't pronounce it une voiture. Same thing here, the last thing that you will hear is this r, voiture, voiture. So it's not here, okay, so clearly you don't pronounce it here. It could be also in that situation when you've got a verb, okay, so elle parle, parle. And then the last thing here that you will hear is the l, l, l. Okay, so here is not pronounced, and it's not pronounced here. You don't say elle, but then you say elle, elle. Elle parle, okay, elle parle. And then, well, it could be also in that case with an adjective, okay, intelligente, Same thing here. When you put this well, actually, you will pronounce the final T, okay, but you don't pronounce this here. Intelligente. Okay, so une voiture, elle parle intelligente. Remember that if you've got, in some situations, the pronoun le, and if it comes after your verb, like in that case, then you will have to pronounce it. Okay, so regarde-le, regarde-le, all right, regarde-le, écoute-le, okay, écoute-le, so here you pronounce it, and then finis-le, okay, regarde-le, écoute-le, finis-le, all right, so when you've got this combination in which you've got this pronoun le after, okay, but then actually it's the same thing. In that case, you've got to pronounce the final e, okay, but then in other cases, you don't. Second situation. Après une voyelle. So after another vowel, like here, for instance, you don't pronounce this e, okay? So in that case, if you want to pronounce it correctly, you should pronounce it like il étudie. Okay, so the last thing that you will pronounce will be the vowel I here. Okay, il étudie. You don't pronounce this here. Okay, let's see another example. Elle joue. So it's, in that case, it's quite interesting because if you look carefully, you've got the combination of the vowel O and U, and together, you know that they produce the sound OU, okay? And it's exactly the same rule, so you've got this after, but then clearly you don't pronounce it. Okay, elle joue. And then, je skie. Okay, exactly the same thing. Je skie. Okay, you get this I, and after that you get the vowel E, but then you don't pronounce it. All right, and it's actually quite interesting because, you know, I just wanted to rewrite the same verbs, but then I will put them at the plural form, and then you get this E, N, T, and actually, it will be exactly the same rule because you don't pronounce this e, and then even if it's at the plural form, so e n t, well, you don't pronounce it. So you will get ils étudient. All right, ils étudient. You don't pronounce that, and it will be exactly the same thing as we had previously. Elle joue. Okay, elle joue. And then tu skis. Well, exactly the same thing, even if you get this ES, well, actually the E is mute, you don't pronounce it, so you don't pronounce the final S either, okay? Étudier is to study, jouer is to play, and then skier is to ski, okay? So, clearly, if you've got this combination A, E, well, you don't pronounce E, I, E, it will be exactly the same thing, you don't pronounce the E, O, same rule, U, same thing. And then if you, as we saw previously, if you combine A and E, and after that you've got the you don't pronounce it. It could be as well this O, E, and E, you don't pronounce it. U, E, and E, you don't pronounce it. So it can be also this A and U together, you will get the sound O, but then you don't pronounce the E if it's coming after. Same thing here, if you've got E and U, and then you get this E, you don't pronounce it. O and U, and after that you've got the E, you don't pronounce it. Remember that it must be followed by whether une consonne, a consonant, or then nothing. Okay, if you've got a vowel, I mean the rule is changing, of course. Okay, so whether a consonant, so une consonne, or then rien, so nothing. Okay, so let's see now the third situation here, when will be muet. Okay, and then the thing goes like, pour certains verbes, au futur et au conditionnel présent, you won't pronounce this e. So if you want to conjugate verbs, and in that case we're talking about verbs from the first group, so ending with er, okay, so we will see that, like here for instance, aimer, okay, to love or to like, and the first form that you get here, it's the future form, le futur simple. And here you've got this conditionnel present form, okay? But then it's exactly the same thing because even if you've got this e here and here, you don't pronounce it. So it will go like j'aimerais, or then j'aimerais. Remember, phonetically, they are the same, okay? J'aimerais, j'aimerais. It could be another verb like adorer, to adore. Tu adoreras, tu adorerais. Okay? Or then, étudier, same thing here, it will go away. Elle étudiera, elle étudierait. Okay? So, j'aimerais, j'aimerais. Tu adoreras, tu adorerais. Elle étudiera, elle étudierait. Quite simple. And now, let's see the number four, the fourth situation where you don't pronounce it. And so that's the rule, à partir de la deuxième syllabe et après, okay? So if you've got a word in which you've got many syllables, think about that. If you've got the here, well, starting at the second place or the second syllable and after, then you don't pronounce it. Let's see how it will go. Well, here it's exactly what we've been seeing because it's the second syllable. So you've got re and then ve and nir, but then clearly you don't pronounce it. So you get revenir, revenir. Okay. Same thing here, appeler, but then you get appeler, appeler, and then samedi. All right. So revenir, appeler, samedi. Okay. Let's see now when they are in the third place. So, bizarrement, but then you will get bizarrement, bizarrement. Exactly the same thing after that, complètement, but then you will get complètement. Okay, so, revenir, appeler, samedi, bizarrement, complètement. And then think about that. Well, it's possible to find it at the fourth place, so it will be the fourth syllable of the word. And then we're talking about, well, in most of the cases, we're talking about the adverbs, and the adverbs that will end with -ement, okay? In most of the cases, you don't pronounce this -e here. La médecine. Une analyse de sang. Une analyse d'urine. Un bêta-bloquant, un contrôle négatif, un contrôle positif, contrôler, un contrôleur médical, un dépistage, dépister, un diurétique, doser, une éprouvette, un examen anabolique, une hormone, un laboratoire, une oxygénation, un prélèvement, un échantillon, prélever, une prévention, un résultat, un test, une transfusion sanguine, des vitamines. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 14, Leçon C. And in this lesson, we'll cover, it will be the second part of this La Médecine topic, so medical terms, okay? And normally the full thing will cover four videos, so after this one, two more, and that will be it, okay? And in that video, we'll see le corps humain, so human body. Let's start now. Un abdomen, un ventre. Sorry, I forgot to put the article here, but it's masculin. Un ventre. Un abdomen, un ventre, un estomac. Une haine. Une aisselle. Une arcade sourcilière. Une articulation, une bouche, un bras, une capacité respiratoire, un cerveau, Des cheveux. Une cheville. Une clavicule. Un cœur. Une colonne cervicale. Une colonne dorsale. Une colonne dorsale. Une colonne vertébrale. Un rachis. Une côte. Un cou. Un coude. Un crâne. Une cuisse. Une dent. Un doigt. Un dos. Une épaule. S'essouffler. Une expiration. Expirer. Un foie. Un front. Un genou. Une inspiration. Inspirer. Un intestin. Une jambe. Une joue. Une lèvre. Un ligament. Une lombaire. Une mâchoire. Une mâchoire inférieure. Une main. Un membre. Un ménisque. Un menton. Le milieu du mollet. Un muscle. Un muscle abducteur. Un muscle abducteur. Un muscle extenseur. Un muscle fléchisseur. Les muscles abdominaux. Les muscles pectoraux. Un nerf. Un nez. Une nuque. Un œil. Une omoplate. Un ongle. Une oreille. Un orteil. Un os. La paume de la main. Une phalange. Un pied. Une plante de pied. Un poignet. Un poing. Un pouce. Un pouls. Un poumon. Un rein. Une respiration. Respirer. Le sang. Le système cardiovasculaire. Le système digestif. Le système nerveux. Le système respiratoire. Un talon. Une tempe. Un tendon. Un tendon d'Achille. Une tête. Un thorax. Un tibia. Un torse. Un torse. Une poitrine. Un tronc. Un ventre. Une vertèbre. Une vessie. Un visage. And that's it. It was a long list, but quite useful, I hope. If you want more videos, then it's right here. Don't forget to like me on Facebook. The address is here. And then if you want more material, then www.imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye bye. Les maladies. Let's start now. Un alitement. Une angine. Une appendicite. Une asphyxie musculaire. Une bronchite. Une brûlure. Une congestion. Une constipation. Une contagion. Une convalescence. Une crampe d'estomac. Une déshydratation. Se déshydrater. Une diarrhée, une dysenterie. Une douleur. Une fièvre. Une gastralgie. Une grippe. Une indigestion. Une indisposition. Une infection. Une inflammation. Oops, sorry. My mistake here. Féminine. Une insomnie. Un lumbago. Un ou une malade. Un malaise. Des maux de dents. Des maux de tête. Des maux d'estomac. Un microbe. Une nausée. Une névralgie. Une palpitation cardiaque. Une pharmacie. Une pneumonie. Un refroidissement. Un rhumatisme. Un rhume. Une toux. Un virus. Un vomissement. Les blessures. So let's start now. Une ampoule au pied. Un arrêt cardiaque. Une articulation déboîtée. Une asphyxie. Un bandage. Bandé. Un blessé. Une blessure. Une blessure grave. Une blessure légère. Une bombe cryogénique. Un bouche à bouche. Un choc. Un claquage. Un coma. Une compresse. Une contusion. Une ecchymose. Un coup de chaleur. Un coup de soleil. Une coupure. Une courbature. Une crampe. Une contracture. Une déchirure. Une rupture. Une déchirure musculaire. Demander du secours. Une écorchure. Une élongation musculaire. Une élongation tendineuse. Une enflure. Un épanchement. Un écoulement. Un épuisement. Un essoufflement. Une fatigue. Une foulure. Une entorse. Une fracture. Une fracture de fatigue. Une fracture ouverte. Un garrot. Un hématome. Une hémorragie. Une hyperthermie. Une hypoglycémie. Une hypothermie. Un infarctus. Une injection intramusculaire. Une injection intraveineuse. Une insolation. Une intervention chirurgicale. Une opération. Une irritation. Une luxation. Un déboîtement. Un œdème. Opérer. Un pansement. Penser. Perdre connaissance. Une plaie. Une plaie ouverte. Un plâtre. Plâtré. Un point de côté. Une pommade. Pratiquer un garrot. Les premiers secours. Une réanimation. Réduire une fracture. Un saignement. Saigner. Secourir. Porter secours. Les secours. Les soins complémentaires. Une souffrance. Souffrir. Une subluxation. Une syncope. Une tendinite. Une tétanisation. Tétanisé. Tordu, déboîté. Les verbes et les prépositions, because many persons have been asking me if it would be possible to actually make videos regarding this topic. So I will put here the first one and then we'll see when I will do the second one, third one, etc. Okay, so let's see. And then, well, first thing that, well, clearly we should have in mind are the les mots clés, so the keywords that we will use, because when we're talking about preposition or construction, I will tend to use these words actually quite often. So quelqu'un, it's actually for someone or somebody, quelque chose, something, and then quelque part, somewhere or someplace. Okay, so let's see the first verb, and the first verb that we'll see is accepter. Okay, and you can see here the three constructions possible. The first one, accepter quelqu'un, quelque chose, or then accepter de plus infinitif, all right, or then accepter que plus subjonctif. D'accord? Donc accepter quelqu'un, accepter quelque chose, accepter de plus verbe à l'infinitif, accepter que plus verbe au subjonctif. Deuxième verbe, accompagner. Accompagner quelqu'un, accompagner quelque chose. Or then it's possible to use this. Accompagner quelque chose de quelque chose. Ok? Accompagner quelqu'un, accompagner quelque chose. Or then, accompagner quelque chose de quelque chose. Verbe numéro 3, admettre. Admettre. Admettre quelqu'un, admettre quelque chose. Well, then it's possible to construct it with admettre plus infinitif, verbe à l'infinitif. Or then, admettre de plus infinitif. En général, forme négative. So in general, if you want to use this structure, then in most of the cases, you will use this admettre at the negative form. Okay? Admirer. Admirer. Okay? So, first one, admirer quelqu'un, admirer quelque chose. Okay, so in that case, so of course, each time I say quelqu'un or quelque chose, it does mean that we don't have any preposition. Okay, admirer quelqu'un de plus verbe à l'infinitif. All right, or then admirer que plus verbe au subjonctif. Okay, donc admirer, admirer quelqu'un, admirer quelque chose. Admirer quelqu'un de plus verbe à l'infinitif, or then admirer que plus verbe au subjonctif. Adorer. Adorer. Adorer quelqu'un, adorer quelque chose. Or then adorer quelqu'un de plus infinitif. Or then it's possible to use this adorer plus verbe à l'infinitif. And the last, but not the least, adorer que plus verbe au subjonctif. Affirmer. Affirmer. Première possibilité, affirmer quelque chose. Pas de préposition. Or then, affirmer plus verbe à l'infinitif. Or then, affirmer que plus verbe à l'indicatif. Okay, remember, you don't put subjonctif in that case, even if you introduce it with que, but then you put indicatif. Aider. First option, aider quelqu'un. So no preposition there. Aider à quelque chose. Or then, aider quelqu'un à, and then the verb should be at the infinitive. Aider quelqu'un, aider à quelque chose, or aider quelqu'un à, and the verb at the infinitive. Aimer. Aimer quelqu'un ou aimer quelque chose. Or then it's possible to just put a verb at the infinitive form after. Aimer plus infinitif. Ok? Then, aimer quelqu'un de plus infinitif. And the last one, aimer que plus subjonctif. And in most of the cases, we tend to use this structure when the verb aimer is conjugated at the conditionnel passé, conditionnel présent form. Ok? So, aimer, and then conditional at the conditional present form, plus que, plus subjonctif. OK? So, quelqu'un, quelque chose, and then with an infinitive form, quelqu'un de plus infinitif, and then que plus subjonctif. Aller. Aller quelque part. So in that case, I've been listing few prepositions. Ok. En, au, dans, à, sous, sur, etc. Ok. Then, aller plus infinitif. Or then, if you want to talk about the place where someone is living, then we put this chez. Ok. Chez quelqu'un. Ok. Aller quelque part. Aller plus infinitif, aller chez quelqu'un. Annoncer. Annoncer quelque chose à quelqu'un. OK? Annoncer quelque chose à quelqu'un. Then, annoncer que plus indicatif. OK? Same thing here. Even if you've got this que, then you don't introduce this subjonctif, but it's just indicative form. We've been doing some videos concerning le participe présent and les adjectifs verbaux, okay? But then in that video, we'll try to see actually, well, the way in some cases they can be tricky, okay? Because, well, the rule is that this participe présent, okay? So I've been making some videos regarding that, so I won't explain again how to make it. But then that's the concept is that in most of the cases, this participe présent will be exactly the same as what we call adjectif verbal. Same thing here. If you don't know what an adjectif verbal is, use the search engine of the channel and then you can find the video that will introduce this adjectif verbal. But the thing that you get to keep in mind is that in most of the cases, they will be exactly the same. Okay, and of course, as usual in French, we've got some exceptions. So I will introduce a few exceptions here, okay, and then you can see the differences because I've been putting them in red. Okay, so I will read them, and then after that, that will be it. So the first one is adhérent, so participe présent, and then adjective verbal goes like adhérent, like that. So you can see the difference is only in the vowel because phonetically it's the same. Same thing here. Well, phonetically it's the same. Communiquant and then communicant. Okay. Here, participe présent, QU, and then adjective verbal, C. All right. Then, convaincant. Same thing here, QU, adjective verbal, convaincant, C. All right. Phonetically, they are the same. Then, émergent. It's quite interesting because you've got this E and A here and here, émergent, phonetically the same. Then équivalent, okay, you've got A here, and then équivalent, you've got E here. Excellent, A, and then excellent with E. Okay, so what you can see is that, well, phonetically they are the same, but then you get to write them in a different way. Let's see the second part of the list now. And then it's here. Fatigant, participe présent, and then phonetically the same. Fatigant, but then you can see that you don't have the U here. Navigant, navigant. Okay. Négligent, and then négligent. Précédent, précédent. Provoquant, provoquant. Résident, résident. Okay, so that's the rule. I mean, if you think about that, phonetically they will be the same, but then, as you can see, a few modifications in the writing. So don't worry because we're only talking about the exceptions, and that's the reason why I wanted to make this video just to show you some exceptions. But then let's, you know, put it as simple as possible. And then the first thing that we've got to keep in mind is that in some cases, well, the ant will be replaced by ent for this adjective verbal. Okay, and then, well, the verbs at the infinitive with G-U-E-R, well, you can see that they can be tricky, so that's the one that you should keep in mind. And the second group of verbs that will be tricky as well will be the verbs, well, regular verbs, but then from, so from the first group, but ending with Q-U-E-R, okay? So that's, I mean, the ones that will be more tricky than the others. Les verbes et les prépositions, just because I've been receiving some quite positive feedback on that, so I thought that maybe we could continue. So it's the second part, and we'll discover 10 or 11 verbs. I'm not really sure about that, but anyway, we've got some keywords that I will use quite often when I will explain the structures that you can make with these verbs. So the first one would be quelqu'un, someone, somebody, quelque chose, something, and then quelque part, somewhere, someplace. Okay, so they will be quite useful. And the first verb that we will see together is appartenir. Okay, so appartenir. And first structure that we can see with appartenir, you use the preposition à, and then appartenir à quelqu'un ou quelque chose. Okay. Second structure, appartenir à quelqu'un, and then you will put the preposition de, and it should be followed by the verb at the infinitive form. Okay. So, appartenir à quelqu'un, appartenir à quelque chose, and then appartenir à quelqu'un de plus infinitif. D'accord? Deuxième verbe, appeler. First structure, no preposition, appeler quelqu'un, and then appeler quelque chose. Okay, second structure, appeler quelqu'un, so no preposition, à. And then you will put, sorry, the verb at the infinitive form. Okay, so appeler quelqu'un, appeler quelque chose, appeler quelqu'un à plus infinitif. D'accord? Verbe suivant, apporter. Apporter quelque chose à quelqu'un. So you can see that you don't have any preposition first here. So apporter quelque chose à quelqu'un. And then, same structure, no preposition, apporter quelque chose à quelque chose. All right, so let's see it one more time. Apporter quelque chose à quelqu'un, apporter quelque chose à quelque chose. Apprendre. Okay, so you can see that I've been putting two meanings, so I will explain to you actually which one is concerned regarding the structure that we will use. So the first structure would be apprendre quelque chose. Apprendre quelque chose, in that case, it will be connected to the meaning learn. So the first meaning of apprendre, to learn. Okay? Apprendre quelque chose, no preposition. Second structure, no preposition. So apprendre quelque chose à quelqu'un. So in that case, this structure would be connected to the teach meaning. Okay, apprendre quelque chose à quelqu'un. Okay, structure suivante, apprendre quelque chose de quelqu'un. Okay, so in that case, this structure would be connected to the learn meaning, apprendre quelque chose de quelqu'un. Okay, apprendre à plus infinitif. Okay, so the verb that you should put after should be at the infinitive form, so the basic form of the verb. Apprendre à plus infinitif. And then apprendre que plus indicatif. Be careful, it's not because we're using this que that it should be followed by the subjonctif. No, 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 no. In that case, you should put indicatif. Okay, so let's see that one more time. Apprendre quelque chose. Okay, connected to learn. Apprendre quelque chose à quelqu'un, connected to teach. Apprendre quelque chose de quelqu'un, learn. Apprendre à plus infinitif, learn. Apprendre que plus indicatif, learn. Okay? Verbe suivant, verbe arranger. Première structure, arranger quelqu'un, arranger quelque chose. So you can see that we don't have any preposition first, okay? So arranger quelqu'un, arranger quelque chose. Second option we would have, second structure, arranger quelque chose à quelqu'un. D'accord? Arranger, arranger quelqu'un, arranger quelque chose à quelqu'un. Verbe suivant, verbe arrêter. Okay, arrêter means to stop. Première structure, pas de préposition, no preposition, so arrang oh, sorry. Arrêter quelqu'un, and then arrêter quelque chose. D'accord? And then arrêter de plus infinitif, so the verb should be at the infinitive form here. Arrêter de plus infinitif. D'accord? So one more time, arrêter quelqu'un, arrêter quelque chose, arrêter de plus verbe à l'infinitif. Arriver. So I've been putting all the meanings not possible but connected to the structures that we will see. Okay, and the first two structures will actually be connected to this arrive translation. Okay, arriver quelque part. Pas de préposition, no preposition. Or in that case, sorry about that. Yeah, you should put the dans, à ou en. Alright, so and all well, composition that you can make with the articles, okay? So it could be dans la, dans le, dans les, then à la, and then à plus le would become au, à plus les would become au, en, etc. So, quelque part, and in that case, of course, you should use this preposition. Or then it could be arrivé de quelque part. Okay, and same thing here. So you could have this de là, du. Remember, du, it's when you combine the preposition de with the article le. Okay, and then de, you combine the preposition de with the article les. Okay, so arriver quelque part. So with these prepositions, and then arriver de quelque part. So de là, du, and des. Arriver, so actually we can translate that with happen, okay? And in that case, arriver quelque chose à quelqu'un, okay? So you can see no preposition, arriver quelque chose à quelqu'un. Arriver à quelqu'un de, and in that case, the verb that comes after should be at the infinitive form, okay? Arriver à quelqu'un de. Okay, and then arriver que, and the verb should be at the subjonctif. Okay, arriver que plus subjonctif. Alright, so one more time. Arriver quelque chose à quelqu'un. Arriver à quelqu'un de plus verbe à l'infinitif. Arriver que plus verbe au subjonctif. And the last meaning would be manage or succeed. It's actually quite simple. Only one structure connected to this meaning, and it's arriver à plus verbe à l'infinitif. Okay, so arriver à plus infinitif. Let's see now the verb attendre. Attendre, and then same thing. So it could be the first meaning would be to wait. Okay, but then we've got this expect meaning as well, so we'll see that right after, but then now it's only connected to wait. First structure, attendre quelqu'un or quelque chose. Okay, so you can see no preposition here. Attendre quelqu'un, attendre quelque chose. Or then second structure, attendre quelqu'un or quelque chose pour. Okay, and then the verb should be at the infinitive form. Attendre quelqu'un ou quelque chose pour plus infinitif. Attendre de plus verbe à l'infinitif. Okay, and the last one, attendre que plus verbe au subjonctif. Okay, so be careful. The verb should be at the subjonctif. Okay, so one more time. Attendre quelqu'un, attendre quelque chose. Attendre quelqu'un, quelque chose pour plus verbe à l'infinitif. Attendre de plus verbe à l'infinitif. Attendre que plus verbe au subjonctif. Okay, and then it can mean as well expect. And then in that case, the structure is attendre quelque chose de quelqu'un. attendre quelque chose de quelqu'un, ok? And in that case, the meaning would be to expect. Les verbes et les prépositions, ok? And then, well, a few keywords that we should definitely see before starting. Quelqu'un, so because I will use them quite often in these videos. So, quelqu'un means someone, somebody, quelque chose, something, quelque part, somewhere, or someplace, okay? And we'll start with the first verb, and it's quite useful because it's avoir, to have. So, let's see the structures that we can make with this verb, okay? So, the first one is avoir quelqu'un. Quelque chose, so you can see that we don't have any preposition right after or right before. Then the second structure we could build or we could make would be avoir quelque chose à, and then the verb that will come after should be at the infinitive form. Okay, avoir quelque chose à plus infinitif, or then just avoir à plus infinitif. Okay, so here are the three structures that we can make with avoir. Avoir quelqu'un, avoir quelque chose, avoir quelque chose à plus infinitif, and then avoir à plus infinitif. Verbe suivant, verbe cacher. Cacher means to hide. And then cacher quelqu'un, cacher quelque chose. So you can see that we don't have any preposition here. Cacher quelque chose à quelqu'un. Same thing, no preposition before. Cacher que. And then be careful because it's not because you introduce the structure of the verb with que that it should be at the subjonctive, because in that case it shouldn't be at the subjonctive form but indicatif. Okay, so cacher que plus indicatif. Okay, so one more time. Cacher quelqu'un, cacher quelque chose à quelqu'un, cacher que plus verbe à l'indicatif. Ok? Verbe suivant, verbe causer. Ok? And you can see that the translation is quite easy. Causer quelque chose. Ok? So no preposition. Causer quelque chose. And then, causer quelque chose à quelqu'un. D'accord? Causer quelque chose. Causer quelque chose à quelqu'un. Actually, it's quite easy, this one. Mm-hmm. Let's see the next one. And of course, it's a bit more tricky. It's the verb changer. Okay, changer. So, first structure, changer quelqu'un, changer quelque chose. Okay, so in that case, you can see no preposition, changer quelqu'un, changer quelque chose. Second structure, changer quelque chose pour quelque chose. Okay. Third structure, changer quelque chose contre quelque chose. Okay. So these two structures, the one with the pour and contre, actually they mean the same thing. Okay. Changer quelqu'un en quelque chose. Or then it could be changer quelque chose en quelque chose. And the last one could be changer de quelqu'un. Or then changer de quelque chose. Alright, so one more time. Changer quelqu'un, changer quelque chose pour quelque chose, changer quelque chose contre quelque chose, changer quelqu'un en quelque chose, changer quelque chose en quelque chose, and then changer de quelqu'un or changer de quelque chose. Verbe suivant, verbe choisir. And then, first structure, choisir quelqu'un, choisir quelque chose. So you can see, we don't have any preposition before. And then it could be choisir entre quelqu'un et quelqu'un. In the same way, we could have choisir entre quelque chose et quelque chose. It could be also choisir ce que. And then the verb should be at the indicatif right after. Okay. And the last one would be choisir de. And the verb should be at the infinitive form. Okay, so one more time. Choisir quelqu'un. Choisir quelque chose. Choisir entre quelqu'un et quelqu'un. Choisir entre quelque chose et quelque chose. Choisir ce que plus verbe à l'indicatif, choisir de plus verbe à l'infinitif. Le verbe suivant est le verbe commencer. Ok, and commencer means to start. Ok, first structure, commencer quelque chose. Ok, no preposition, just commencer quelque chose. And then it could be also commencer par quelque chose. D'accord? And then commencer par, and then the verb should be at the infinitive form after. And the last one would be commencer à plus verbe à l'infinitif. Ok, so one more time. Commencer quelque chose. Commencer par quelque chose. Commencer par plus verbe à l'infinitif. Commencer à plus verbe à l'infinitif. D'accord? Verbe suivant, verbe comprendre. Comprendre quelqu'un, comprendre quelque chose. So you can see that we don't put any prepositions before. Comprendre ce que plus verbe à l'indicatif. Comprendre que plus verbe à l'indicatif. And then comprendre que plus verbe au subjonctif. So you can see that we've got both options here. Okay, so I won't explain in this video the reason why, because I've been doing a video that concern or many videos that cover the subjunctive topic. Okay, and well, the situations when you should use this indicative or the subjunctive. So if you're not sure about the difference between the two, then I definitely advise you to watch these videos because, well, you will understand the difference between the two. Okay, one more time. Comprendre quelqu'un, comprendre quelque chose. Comprendre ce que plus verbe à l'indicatif. Comprendre que plus verbe à l'indicatif, comprendre que plus verbe au subjonctif. Verbe suivant, verbe connaître. Connaître is, well, means to know. And then first structure, no preposition, connaître quelqu'un, connaître quelque chose. Second structure, connaître quelque chose, à quelque chose. D'accord? Connaître quelqu'un, connaître quelque chose. Connaître quelque chose à quelque chose. Verbe suivant, verbe conseiller. Conseiller could be translated by advice or counsel. Première utilisation, première structure, no preposition, conseiller quelqu'un. OK. And then, conseiller quelque chose à quelqu'un. D'accord? And then, conseiller à quelqu'un de. And the verb should be at the infinitive form right after. Or then the last one, conseiller que plus subjonctif. OK? So one more time. Conseiller, conseiller quelqu'un, conseiller quelque chose à quelqu'un, conseiller à quelqu'un de plus infinitif, conseiller que plus subjonctif. OK? Verbe suivant, verbe coûter. OK. Coûter quelque chose. Pas de préposition. Coûter quelque chose. And then it could be coûter quelque chose à quelqu'un. And then coûter de plus verbe à l'infinitif. OK. So coûter quelque chose. Coûter quelque chose à quelqu'un. Coûter de plus infinitif. Les verbes et les prépositions. Okay, but then first we should definitely see some keywords because I will use them when I will explain the structures that we'll make with the verbs. So quelqu'un means someone, somebody, quelque chose, something, quelque part, somewhere, someplace. So quelqu'un, quelque chose, quelque part. Okay. First verb, and it's craindre. Okay, a bit of translation here in English. So let's see now the structures that we can make with these verbs. And the first one is craindre quelqu'un, craindre quelque chose. Okay, so you can see that we don't put any preposition. And then it can be craindre pour quelque chose. Okay, and then we can use this preposition de, craindre de. And then the verb that will come after should be at the infinitive form. And the last option we've got is craindre que, and then the verb should be at the subjonctif. Okay, so let's see them one more time. Craindre quelqu'un, craindre quelque chose, craindre pour quelque chose, craindre de plus verbe à l'infinitif, craindre que plus verbe au subjonctif. Verbe suivant. Croire, and croire means to believe. So, you can see the structures here. The first one, la première, craindre quelqu'un, croire quelqu'un, croire quelque chose. Okay, so you can see that we don't put any preposition here. Second option would be croire à quelque chose. Option numéro 3, croire en quelqu'un, croire en quelque chose. Okay. Then, croire quelque chose de quelqu'un. Then, croire, and after that you just put a verb at the infinitive. And the last option we would have would be croire que plus indicatif. Okay, remember, it's not because we're using this que that we will put all the verbs at the subjonctif. Okay, I've been making some videos regarding this topic, so, and especially in that case with croire, it should be at the indicatif. Okay, so one more time. Croire quelqu'un, croire quelque chose. Croire à quelque chose. Croire en quelqu'un, croire en quelque chose. Croire quelque chose de quelqu'un. Croire plus verbe à l'infinitif. Croire que plus verbe à l'indicatif. And the next verb is décider. Décider, okay. First structure, décider quelque chose. So you can see that we don't put any preposition here. Décider quelque chose, okay. Second structure, décider de quelque chose. Décider quelqu'un à, and the verb should be at the infinitive after, okay. Décider de, and the verb should be at the infinitive after. Or then, décider que plus indicatif. Okay, remember, it's not with subjonctif, but indicatif. Okay, so one more time. Décider quelque chose. Décider de quelque chose. Décider quelqu'un à plus verbe à l'infinitif. Décider de plus verbe à l'infinitif. Décider que plus verbe à l'indicatif. Verbe suivant, verbe découvrir. Découvrir, to discover. It's actually quite simple because we've got two structures possible. The first one, no preposition. Découvrir quelqu'un, découvrir quelque chose. Okay. And then, découvrir que plus indicatif. D'accord? Donc, découvrir quelqu'un, découvrir quelque chose, découvrir que plus verbe à l'indicatif. Verbe suivant, verbe demander. Première structure, demander quelqu'un, demander quelque chose. So, no preposition here. Demander quelqu'un, demander quelque chose. Deuxième structure, demander quelque chose à quelqu'un. Demander à quelqu'un de, and the verb should be at the infinitive form after. Okay, so demander à quelqu'un de plus infinitif. And the last one, demander que plus verbe au subjonctif. Okay, so one more time. Demander quelqu'un, demander quelque chose, demander quelque chose à quelqu'un, demander à quelqu'un de plus verbe à l'infinitif, demander que plus verbe au subjonctif. And then the verb descendre. Okay, means go down, take down. Première possibilité, descendre quelque part. Okay, descendre quelque part. Deuxième possibilité, descendre quelqu'un, descendre quelque chose. No preposition here. Or then it could be descendre de quelqu'un. Or then descendre de quelque chose. And the last one, descendre plus, verbe à l'infinitif. Ok, so one more time. Descendre quelque part, descendre quelqu'un, descendre quelque chose, descendre de quelqu'un, descendre de quelque chose, and then descendre plus, verbe à l'infinitif. Détester, détester quelqu'un, détester quelque chose. No preposition. Détester quelqu'un, détester quelque chose. D'accord? Then it could be détester plus, verbe à l'infinitif. Détester que plus verbe au subjonctif. Ok, so one more time. Détester quelqu'un, détester quelque chose. Détester plus verbe à l'infinitif. Détester que plus verbe au subjonctif. Dire. So we've got two pages for this dire because it's quite rich when we're talking about the structures that we can make with these verbs. Okay, so the first one, dire quelque chose. So no preposition here. Dire quelque chose. Okay, so you can have dire quelque chose à quelqu'un. It's also possible to say dire quelque chose de quelqu'un or quelque chose. Dire quelque chose sur quelqu'un ou quelque chose. Okay, so one more time. Dire quelque chose à quelqu'un, dire quelque chose de quelqu'un, dire quelque chose de quelque chose, dire quelque chose sur quelqu'un, dire quelque chose sur quelque chose. Ok? Second page, as I said. Dire plus infinitif. Dire que plus verbe à l'indicatif. Dire ce que plus verbe à l'indicatif. Dire à quelqu'un de plus infinitif. Dire à quelqu'un que plus subjonctif. All right, so you can see that in that case, well, we can see that que here is followed by the indicatif, but then à quelqu'un que should be followed by the subjonctif. Okay, if you don't know how to make them, then check the channel and try to find the subjonctive videos and I explain you how to make them. But then one more time, so dire plus infinitif, dire que plus indicatif, dire ce que plus indicatif, dire à quelqu'un de plus infinitif, dire à quelqu'un que plus subjonctif. Discuter. Discuter quelque chose. So you can see no preposition here. But then it's also possible to use this de. Discuter de quelque chose. Or then, discuter sur quelque chose. Okay, so discuter quelque chose, discuter de quelque chose, discuter sur quelque chose. Des participes passés invariables. So I've been thinking about this thing and then, well, we've been covering the participe passé already a long time ago and we've been seeing that we need them if we want to structure or to compose or to make composed tenses. And then in many situations, when we put the pronoun at a certain place, we've got to put at the end of this participe passé, whether the feminine or then the plural. But then there is a list of participe passé that will actually never change for a good reason. It's whether they are coming from verbe intransitif, or then they are coming from what we call verbe transitif indirect, and clearly that will give us this list of participes passés invariables. So it does mean that they will never actually be affected by this feminine thing that you've got to put at the end, or then the plural thing that you've got to put at the end, they will stay the same. Okay, so of course the list was a bit longer than what I've been selecting, but then, well, I've been selecting the most used verbs that normally students at this level should know or should use. Okay, so that's the reason why the list is quite long, but not as long as it could be. All right, so let's start now with the first one. So what I will do, I will read each time first the participe passé here, okay, and then after that I will read the infinitive form. Okay, so let's start now. Abouti, aboutir. Aboyer, aboyer. Accéder, accéder. Agir, agir. Appartenu, appartenir. Atterri, atterrir. Bâiller, bâiller. Bavarder, bavarder. Bondi, bondir. Briller, briller. Capituler, capituler. Circuler, circuler. Consister, consister. Contribuer, contribuer. Correspondu, correspondre. Déjeuner, déjeuner. Déplu, déplaire. Dîner, dîner. Divorcer, divorcer. Dormir, dormir. Durer, durer. Éternuer, éternuer. Été, être. Évoluer, évoluer. Exister, exister. Failli, faillir. Fallu, falloir. Fonctionner, fonctionner. Hésiter, hésiter. Insister, insister. Oops, sorry, mistake here. It should be ER, okay? Lutter, lutter. Marcher, marcher. Mentir, mentir. Naviguer, naviguer. Neiger, neiger. Participer, participer. Patienter, patienter. Persister, persister. Plus, plaire. Plus, pleuvoir. Just one second to remind you, and we saw that previously, that these two verbs, plaire and pleuvoir, share the same participe passé. Okay, so it's not a mistake in that case, they just have the same participe passé. Procéder, procéder. Profiter, profiter. Réagir, réagir. Régner, régner. Résider, résider. Résister, résister. Ressembler, ressembler. Rire, rire. Séjourner, séjourner. Sembler, sembler. Souper, souper. Sourire, sourire. Stationner, stationner. Succéder, succéder. Suffit, suffire. Surgit, surgir, surgir. survécu, survivre, sympathiser, sympathiser, tarder, tarder, trembler, trembler, tricher, tricher, triompher, triompher, voyager, voyager. Les conjugaisons irrégulières. When we're talking especially about les verbes du premier groupe en CER. Okay. So if you remember correctly, well, I told you that when we're talking about the first group of verbs ending with er, we're talking about regular verbs, which is the case, but then we've got some subgroups, and these groups actually they will have to be, or the verbs in these groups will have to be slightly modified during conjugation for a good reason. You'll see why. Okay, so I wanted to take this verb lancer. Lancer is to throw something or then to launch something, and well, that's the thing. We will have three tenses that will be concerned by these modifications. The first one will be le présent, then l'imparfait, then le passé simple. We don't really use that much le passé simple, but still it's quite important to actually introduce, I mean, this tense and to show you, I mean, what modifications we'll have. Okay, and then the other thing will be the form of le participe présent, which is quite useful to actually see. When we're talking about le présent, actually the only form that will be affected or modified somehow will be the nous form. Okay, and if you take 1 minute to actually think about that, normally if we would respect the rule, so for the regular verbs, we should write the verb like LAN C, so without the CD here, and then ONS, okay? But then phonetically, we would get l'encon, okay? Nous l'encon, and then the problem that we would have would be, well, difficulty to make the connection with this form and the infinitive, because the infinitive is lancé, okay? And if we get this form l'encon, actually it would be quite difficult to really make the connection between them. So just to get the sound s that we've got in the infinitive, well, we only need to put this cd, okay, and we'll get this nous lançons. All right, so and that's the only modification we will have to make for this group or subgroup, if you want, of irregular verbs. Okay, it will be exactly the same thing for the imparfait form. Okay, so I did put this je and tu because they have the same ending here, but it will be exactly the same thing. So instead of just putting this c here, you will put this cd and you will get je lançais, tu lançais. Okay, for the passé simple, it will be exactly the same thing. So we only need to put this cd and we'll get il lança. All right, and then participe présent, exactly the same modification. Just need to put this cd to get the s sound, lançant. All right, so let's have a look at the imparfait form. And the imparfait form goes like je lançais, tu lançais, il lançait, nous lancions. So you can see that here you don't need to put the cd because when you combine c and e, well, it's the sound s. Okay, vous lanciez, so exactly the same thing for the same reason, and then il lançait. Okay, so you can see the modifications here, 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 and here. Okay, for the present form, je lance, tu lances, il lance, nous lançons, so as I said, it's here, okay, vous lancez, il lance. So clearly for all the forms, all the other forms, you don't modify it. I mean, you just respect the rule, when we're talking about the regular verbs, okay? But then the only thing is here, as I said, for nous, then in that case, you get to put la cédille. And then let's see the passé simple. Je lançais, tu lanças, il lança, nous lançâmes, vous lançâtes, ils l'insèrent. So you can see that there is only one form that won't be affected by that, but then all the others will need to be modified with the city, like here. Okay? So remember, présent, imparfait, passé simple, and then participe présent will be the tenses and the forms affected by these or these modifications. Les conjugaisons irrégulières, and we're talking about the verbs from the first group ending with GER. Okay, because if you remember carefully, when I introduced the first group, it was a long time ago, I know, but then I said that, well, actually the first group of verbs are regular verbs, and that's true. I mean, for the endings, it won't be really a problem, but then for some subgroups, we will have some modifications, and this is the one of the subgroup that we will talk about, verbs ending with GER, and we'll see the reason why we've got these modifications. I wanted to take a simple and useful verb, so it's bouger. Bouger is to move, okay? And then we will see that the tenses that will be affected by these modifications will be le présent, l'imparfait, and then le passé simple. Okay, and then we'll have this participe présent form that will be also affected by that. Okay, but then when we're talking about le présent, actually the good news is that we'll have only one form that will be affected or modified, and this is the nous form. Okay, so if you have a look, and if we would respect the rule, we should write it like nous and then B-O-U-G, so without this E here, O-N-S. But then let's just imagine that the E is not here. Phonetically, we would get the sound bougon, nous bougon. And then the problem is that it would be difficult to actually make a connection with the infinitive bougon, okay? And the infinitive is bouger, je, 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 okay? So, g and je, all right? So the only way, or the only possibility that we've got to make actually this phonetical connection with this form and the infinitive is by adding this E here, okay? And so when you put this E here, you will get the sound bougeon, okay? And in that case, you know what verbs we are, or what verb we are talking about. Nous bougeons, all right? So it's only this nous form that will be affected at the present tense. If you're talking about imparfait, then, well, I did put this je and tu, actually, but then we'll see a bit later that we'll have more forms affected by it. But then, for the same reason, and with the same tool, so adding this e, we will actually have the connection, phonetical connection with the infinitive. Je bougeais, tu bougeais. Alright, for the passé simple, it will be exactly the same thing, so I did put this il, but then we'll see that other persons are concerned as well. Il bougea. Okay, so exactly the same thing here for the participe présent, so we will get bougeant. Alright, so let's have a look now at the present form. Je bouge, tu bouges, il bouge, nous bougeons, vous bougez, il bouge. Okay, so as I said, you can see that we've got only the new form that will be modified, because all the other forms, well, they are exactly respecting the rules of the regular verbs. And then imparfait, it will go like je bougeais, tu bougeais, il bougeait, nous bougions, vous bougiez, il bougeait. So if you look carefully, it's actually quite interesting because nous and vous are not concerned by that, just because if you remember, when we combine G and I, we get the sound J, okay? So that's the reason why we don't need to add this E here, okay? But then it's here, it's here, it's here, and it's also here for the plural, okay? Let's have a look at the passé simple now. Je bougeais, tu bougeas, il bougea, nous bougeâmes, vous bougeâtes, ils bougèrent. Okay, so if you look carefully, then it's here, it's here, it's here, it's here, and it's here. So actually there is only this il at the plural form that won't be affected or modified. Okay, So remember, le présent, l'imparfait, le passé simple and le participe présent will be the forms or tenses that will be affected or modified. Les conjugaisons irrégulières, and especially we're talking about the first group of verbs ending with er, and in that case, we'll see the verbs that will end with oyer. Okay, just wanted to take a useful verb and, well, envoyer, to send, is actually quite useful. And so we'll see in this video that when we're talking about these verbs, so this subgroup of verbs that normally should be regular, well, they will be irregular, but, and it will only affect l'indicatif présent, le futur simple, le conditionnel présent, and then le subjonctif présent. Okay, so we'll see the conjugation together. So for the indicatif présent, let's see. So it will go like, j'envoie, tu envoies, il envoie, nous envoyons, vous envoyez, ils envoient. Okay, so you can see that actually, here, here, here and here, it's a bit different than normally it should be if we would respect the rule. So let's see now for the futur simple. J'enverrai, tu enverras, il enverra, nous enverrons, vous enverrez, ils enverront. Okay, so now you can see that there is a big difference between what we saw, I mean, for the main group of verbs from the first group and this one, because actually, you know, enverrai form is quite far in a way from the envoyer, okay? So let's see now, conditionnel présent, well, clearly it will be the same construction or the same idea of construction, so same modification, j'enverrai, tu enverrais, il enverrait, nous enverrions, vous enverriez, ils enverraient. Okay? And then let's see now le subjonctif présent. Que j'envoie, que tu envoies, qu'il envoie, que nous envoyons, que vous envoyez, qu'ils envoient. Okay? And then you can see that here, 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 and here, it's a bit different than what it should be normally if we would respect the rule for the verbs of the first group. So remember, when we're talking about the verbs ending with O-Y-E-R, then the following tenses will be affected and modified. So indicatif présent, futur simple, conditionnel présent, and then subjonctif présent. Okay? Check the video one more time if you really need to remember it, because it can be tricky in some way, because especially for the futur simple and conditionnel présent, I mean phonetically indicatif présent and then subjonctif présent, they don't really change that much. But then if you've got to talk or if you've got to speak with someone, futur simple and conditionnel, I mean modification is quite big. Les conjugaisons irrégulières, and will especially work on les verbes that will end with U-Y-E-R. Okay? Les verbes en U-Y-E-R. And I wanted to take, well, simple verb. The verb is essuyer, so it means to wipe. Okay? Essuyer. And we'll see that, well, this verb, like the others, that will end with U-Y-E-R, well, it will be a bit difficult, or they will change a little bit. So even if it's a regular verb, so it belongs to the first group of verbs ending with E-R, okay? But then you'll see that few modifications will be found. So we're talking about l'indicatif présent. We will see that le futur simple will be concerned as well. And then conditionnel présent and subjonctif présent, okay? So the for the other tenses, actually, these verb will behave like all the other regular verbs ending with er. Okay, so let's see now le présent, and we'll have a look. So it's j'essuie, tu essuies, il essuie, nous essuyons, vous essuyez, ils essuient. Okay, and if you look carefully, then you can see that for the first form here, Actually, this y is changing and now it's e, okay? Same thing here, and then it will be exactly the same thing here, okay? For nous and vous, actually, it does respect the rule for the first group or for the verbs ending with er, so actually you don't really modify it. You just put this y and after that the ending, so y and the ending, okay? But then keep in mind that for the je, tu, il, and then il, in that case you can see that this y will be changed and it will be replaced by i, okay? So let's see now le futur simple. J'essuierai, tu essuieras, il essuiera, nous essuierons, vous essuierez, ils essuieront. Okay, so it's exactly the same thing that, I mean, you can see that this Y will be changed and modified and it will be replaced by this I. And you can see that in that case here for the futur simple form, it does concern all the forms. So je, tu, il, elle, nous, vous, il, elle. Okay, so let's see now for the conditionnel présent. J'essuierai, tu essuierais, il essuierait, nous essuierions, vous essuieriez, ils essuieraient. And it's exactly the same modification, so this Y is changed and modified with E here, so and it does affect all the persons. Okay, and so finally, let's see le subjonctif présent. Que j'essuie, que tu essuies, qu'il essuie, que nous essuyons, que vous essuyez, and then qu'ils essuient. Okay, and exactly as we had for the present form of the indicatif, so the one we saw in just the first one. So same thing here. So Y is changed and replaced by I, okay, for je, tu, and il, and same thing for il at the plural form. So that's the only modifications you need to do, okay? Endings are staying the same and they don't change at all, okay? So let's remember that if you've got these verbs, so ending with U, Y, ER, well, indicatif présent will be slightly modified as we saw, futur simple, conditionnel présent, and then subjonctif présent as well. Les conjugaisons irrégulières, and then we'll focus on les verbes en A, Y, ER. Okay, so the verbs that will end with A, Y, ER. Okay, so I wanted to take a classic verb that we tend to use quite often, and it's payer, to pay. Payer, okay, so A, Y, ER here. And we'll see that even if it belongs to the first group, so ending with ER, so regular group, this verb will be slightly modified, and it will concern the following tenses: indicatif présent, futur simple, conditionnel présent, and then subjonctif présent. So it does mean that for all the other tenses, actually these verbs will follow the rule, so the endings will be the same, and then the way we construct and the way we build the forms will be the same. But then for indicatif présent, futur simple, conditionnel présent, and then subjonctif présent, so we'll see together that we'll have slight or little changes, okay? So we'll start with the présent. So je paie, tu paies, il paie, nous payons, vous payez, il paie. All right, so what you can see is that this Y actually disappears and is replaced by this I. All right, so like here, so it does concern the je, tu, il. Actually, for nous and vous, you can see that it's here, so it's not a problem. So it does follow the normal rule of conjugation for the first of the verbs of the first group. Sorry, and then for il, the plural form, it's exactly the same as we have for je, tu, and il. So you change this y and you put i instead. Okay, so that's the way it should be done, and that's the way I was taught when I was young. But then the good news is that actually you've got another option for this PY group or AY group, because it is now allowed to write them or to write these verbs like that as well. Okay, so it's a good news because it does mean that in fact it is possible to write them like you should write them, you know, when you, because they belong to the first group of verbs. So it can goes like that. So je paie, tu paies, il paie, nous payons, vous payez, and then il paie. Okay, and in that case it's quite funny because we tend to make the difference maybe in pronunciation. So between this one, je paie, and then some persons can pronounce je paye. Okay, tu paies, tu payes, il paie, il paye. Here it's the same. Nous payons, vous payez, il paie, and then il paye. Okay, and then future simple. So as you can see, I've been dividing the screen in two, so it does mean that it will be the same. So we'll see first the official and well, the way l'Académie française would like us to write it or to say it. So je paierai, tu paieras, il paiera, nous paierons, vous paierez, and then ils paieront. Okay, so you can see that it's exactly the same thing. This Y is gone and it's replaced by this E for each forms. Okay, but then it's also possible to use this je paierai, tu paieras, il paiera, nous paierons, vous paierez, ils paieront. Okay, so it is possible and it is an option for you to keep this Y, and actually it won't be considered as a mistake, or it shouldn't be anyway. And then let's see now le conditionnel présent. So je paierai, tu paierais, il paierait, nous paierions, vous paieriez, il paierait. Okay, and it's exactly the same thing. So it is allowed to use this je paierai, tu paierais, il paierait, nous paierions, vous paieriez, il paierait. Okay, so it's a good news. It's possible to use this Y and to keep it if you want it, or then if you want to respect the official rule, you change this Y and you put this E instead. Okay, and let's see now le subjonctif présent. Que je paye, que tu payes, qu'il paye, or then if you want que je paie, que tu payes, qu'il paie. Que nous payons, que vous payiez, qu'il paie. Ok, subjonctif présent, que je paye, ou que je paie, que tu payes, que tu paies, qu'il paye, que nous payons, que vous payez, qu'il paie, ou qu'il paye. Ok, so it's actually quite good, I mean, because you can see that you've got two options, which is quite rare in French. Normally you've got one rule and then you should respect it. So for this verb actually, and for the group of verbs that will end with AYER, so you will have whether the option of respecting the rule and then make these little modifications, or then if you want to keep, well, the normal rule for the AR verbs, then it's possible. Okay, so keep in mind that indicatif présent, futur simple, conditionnel présent, and subjonctif présent are concerned. Les conjugaisons irrégulières, and we'll see especially the verbs that will end with ELER. Okay, so verbs from the first group, so regular verbs, but then in some cases they will be a little bit modified. Okay, but then first thing that we should say is that the verbs like appeler, s'appeler, rappeler, se rappeler, or then interpeller, actually they won't follow the rules or the rule that we will see in this video. Okay, so I will make a special video right after this one. Okay, and then we'll see how they are modified, because they are modified as well in a way. Okay, but then they don't follow the rule that we'll see in this video. Okay, so I wanted to take this verb geler, to freeze. Okay, and so we'll see that so geler will actually be slightly modified. Okay, and it will concern the following tenses: indicatif présent, futur simple, conditionnel présent, and then subjonctif présent. For all the other tenses, actually, je l'ai will be conjugated like it should be, or like the other verbs from this first group are conjugated. Okay, so we'll start with the present and we'll see the forms. Je gèle, tu gèles, il gèle, nous gelons, vous gelez, il gèle. Okay, and so what you can see is that je, tu, il, and then il will be concerned by these changes, and in that case we're only talking about this accent grave. Okay, so you will have to remember to put this accent grave on the top of e for je, tu, il, and then il at the plural. If you look carefully for nous and vous, you don't change, you don't modify it, you just keep it like that and respect the rule of conjugation or construction of conjugation. Okay, so je gèle, tu gèles, il gèle, but then nous gelons, vous gelez, il gèle. Okay, so let's see now for the futur simple. Je gèlerai, tu gèleras, il gèlera, nous gèlerons, vous gèlerez, ils gèleront. Okay, so in that case you can see that all the forms are concerned, and it's exactly the same modification, so you need to put this accent grave on the top of the first E here. J'ai, okay, so gèlerai, gèlera, gèlera, gèleront, gèlerai, gèleront. Okay, so if we're talking about conditionnel present now, we'll see the forms. Je gèlerai, tu gèlerais, il gèlerait, nous gèlerions, vous gèleriez, il gèlerait. Okay, so what you can see, it's that it's exactly the same modification and it will concern all the forms. So, accent grave on the top of the first E. Gèlerai, 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 gèlerions, gèleriez, gèlerait. For the subjonctif present now, it will go like que je gèle, que tu gèles, qu'il gèle, que nous gelions, que vous geliez, qu'il gèle. Okay, so the modification will concern je, tu, il, and then il at the plural form. For nous and vous, actually, you don't modify it, you just keep it like that, and you put the normal endings for the subjonctif present. So, que je gèle, que tu gèles, qu'il gèle, and then qu'il gèle. Okay, so remember that if we're talking about these verbs, so the verbs of the first group ending with E, L, E, R, the following tenses will be modified, so indicatif présent, futur simple, conditionnel présent, and then subjonctif présent. Les conjugaisons irrégulières, and we'll see especially, well, the verbs like appeler, s'appeler, rappeler, se rappeler, and then interpeller. All these verbs, okay, so ending with E, L, E, R, but then the verbs that will be part of the appeler family verbs, okay? So we'll see that I took this example, so appeler, okay? And then we'll see that the following tenses will be concerned by these changes. So we're talking about indicatif présent, futur simple, conditionnel présent, and then subjonctif présent. It does mean that for all the other tenses, actually, appeler will follow the rule of the construction of conjugation of the verbs from the first group, so ending with er, okay, but then for these tenses it will be a bit different, okay, and that's exactly what we'll see in this video, and we'll start of course with the present form. So it will go like j'appelle, tu appelles, il appelle, nous appelons, vous appelez, ils appellent. Okay, so if you look carefully, you can see that the je, tu, il, and then the il and the plural forms are concerned, because you can see that we will double the L. Okay, you will have to put another one. Okay, and then it's quite interesting, because as we saw in the previous video, if you have, you know, double L like that, it will affect the pronunciation of the E. So actually it will open the sound, and that's the reason why you will get the sound est, ok? J'appelle, all right? So, j'appelle, tu appelles, il appelle. And now, for nous and vous, actually, they follow the rule, but then you keep only one L. So that's the reason why you will get the sound appelons. Okay, this E is mute or silent. Appelons, and then vous appelez. Okay, and back to this open E. Okay, so double L, so appel. All right, so j'appelle, tu appelles, il appelle, nous appelons, vous appelez, ils appellent. Okay, so keep in mind that je, tu, il, and then il are concerned, and that you've got to double the L. Mm-hmm. Let's see now for the futur simple. J'appellerai, tu appelleras, il appellera, nous appellerons, vous appellerez, ils appelleront. So in that case, for the futur simple, all the forms are concerned, and it's exactly the same modification that we saw previously, so you've got to double the L, okay? And it will affect all the forms, so remember, you double the L, so it does open the sound of this E, and you get E, okay? J'appellerai, tu appelleras, il appellera, nous appellerons, vous appellerez, ils appelleront. Okay, let's see now le conditionnel présent. And it will be exactly the same thing. J'appellerai, tu appellerais, il appellerait, nous appellerions, vous appelleriez, ils appelleraient. Okay, so same thing, you get to double the L and it does concern all the forms if you can look carefully. So j'appellerai, tu appellerais, il appellerait, nous appellerions, vous appelleriez, ils appelleraient. Okay. And last but not least, le subjonctif présent. Que j'appelle, que tu appelles, qu'il appelle, que nous appelions, que vous appeliez, qu'ils appellent. Okay. And here you can see that je, tu, il, and il at the plural form are concerned by that. So same thing, you double the L and then you open the sound of this E here. J'appelle, que tu appelles, qu'il appelle. And then here, you just keep the form and you just keep the normal ending. Que nous appelions, que vous appeliez, qu'ils appellent. Okay? So remember that for all the verbs that belong to this family of verb appeler, okay, appeler, s'appeler, rappeler, se rappeler, interpeller as well, okay, so they will follow the rule, of course, for the endings, but then they will have some modifications, and as we saw, it will concern l'indicatif présent, le futur simple, le conditionnel présent, and then le subjonctif présent. Les conjugaisons irrégulières, and we'll see especially the verbs that will end with a T-E-R, okay, so regular verbs from the first group ending with E-R, okay, but then we'll see that these verbs will be, in some cases, a bit different. And then what we should keep in mind is that the verbs from the, these family of verbs, so you can see that jeter is the first one, and after that all the verbs will be based on jeter, so déjeter, interjeter, projeter, rejeter, and then surjeter. Well, these verbs won't follow the rule, or they will actually follow another rule. So all the things that we'll see in this video, they won't concern these verbs. Okay, so I've been, choosing a verb acheter, quite useful. It means to buy, and as you can see, it's a T-E-R, so first group, but then we'll see that for the indicative present tense, futur simple, conditionnel present, and then subjonctif present, it will be slightly different, okay? For all the other tenses, actually, you just respect the rule that we saw, concerning the construction of the conjugation for all the other tenses. I mean, it will follow the rule, okay? So now we'll see the present form, and then it goes like, j'achète. Tu achètes, il achète, nous achetons, vous achetez, ils achètent. And so you can see that the only modifications modification we will have to do will be to put an accent grave on the top of this E here, okay? And it will concern only je, tu, il, and then il at the plural form. Okay? For nous and vous, actually, you don't change, and you just respect the rule or the rule that we saw concerning the construction of the present tense for the first group of verbs, so ending with er. Okay? But then remember that you get to put it, and then you will have to pronounce it. So it goes like j'achète, tu achètes, il achète, and then here ils achètent. Okay? After that, nous achetons, vous achetez. Remember this here is silent or mute. Okay? So for the future simple, j'achèterai, tu achèteras, il achètera, nous achèterons, vous achèterez, ils achèteront. So here you can see that all the forms will be concerned and affected or modified. Okay, so it's the same rule. So you will put this accent grave here and then you will change the pronunciation. So you will get this e, achèterait, achètera, achètera, achèteront, achèterait, achèteront. Okay? We're talking about le conditionnel présent, it will be well the same. J'achèterai, tu achèterais, il achèterait, nous achèterions, vous achèteriez, ils achèteraient. Okay? So, same thing, accent grave here, and then it will affect all the forms. J'achèterai, tu achèterais, il achèterait, nous achèterions, vous achèteriez, ils achèteraient. Okay? And last but not least, let's see le subjonctif présent. Que j'achète, que tu achètes, qu'il achète, que nous achetions, que vous achetiez, qu'ils achètent. Okay? And then, same thing, accent grave, and it will concern je, tu, il, elle, and then il, elle at the plural form. For nous and vous, you don't change it. Okay? Que j'achète, que tu achètes, qu'il achète, and then plural form, qu'ils achètent. Okay, well, that's it. So remember that for this ETER, you will have to modify at the indicatif présent, at the futur simple, at the conditionnel présent, and subjonctif présent for all the other tenses. The verb will behave like a normal ER verb. Les conjugaisons irrégulières, and we'll see especially, well, the verbs that will be constructed based on jeter. Okay, so you get jeter and then well verbs like déjeter, interjeter, projeter, rejeter, surjeter. So they are from the same family and we're talking about this jeter. So that's the reason why we will see the example of jeter. So jeter actually, jeter quelque chose, to throw something or then to pitch something. It could be a ball or it could be a stone, whatever. But then we'll see that actually the following tenses will be affected by these changes. So we're talking about indicatif présent, futur simple, conditionnel présent, and then subjonctif présent. So it does mean that for all the other tenses, will actually jeter will follow the rule. So the rule from the first group of verbs, so er, okay. But then for these tenses, we'll see that we will have little changes, and we'll see right away what are these changes for the présent form. And it goes like je jette, tu jettes, il jette, nous jetons, vous jetez, and then il jette. So what we can see here is that je, tu, il, and il will be affected by these changes. And well, the only change that you will have to make is that you will have to double the T here. Okay, normally you should have only one and then you will double it. And by putting two T like that, then it will open the sound of this E, so you will get jette. Okay, je jette, tu jettes, il jette. And then here you don't touch it, jetons, vous jetez. Okay, and then back to the change, il jette. Alright, so you double this letter T here. Okay. And then let's see now for le futur simple. Je jetterai, tu jetteras, il jettera, nous jetterons, vous jetterez, ils jetteront. So we can see that here this modification will affect all the forms, okay? And it's, well, exactly the same modification as we did previously for the present form. So you double this letter. Jetterai, jettera, jettera, jetteront, jetterai, jetteront. And then for the conditional present form, je jetterai, tu jetterais, il jetterait, nous jetterions, vous jetteriez, il jetterait. Okay, so exactly the same modification, and it will affect, as for the future, it will affect all the persons. So you double your D here, okay, and you get je jetterai, tu jetterais, il jetterait, nous jetterions, vous jetteriez, il jetterait. Okay, and let's see now how le subjonctif présent will be affected. Que je jette, que tu jettes, qu'il jette, que nous jetions, que vous jetiez, and then qu'il jette. So what can we see here? We can see that je, tu, il, and then il will be affected because you will have to, as we did previously, double this letter. Okay, but then nous and vous, actually, you don't touch them. You just follow the rule of construction of the subjonctif présent for the verbs from the first group. Okay, so que je jette, que tu jettes, qu'il jette, que nous jetions, que vous jetiez, and then qu'il jette. And that's it. So keep in mind that for all the verbs that will belong to this jeter family, then indicatif présent, futur simple, conditionnel présent, then subjonctif présent will have, I mean, the little changes that we saw, okay, for all the other tenses, well, no modifications, just follow the rules that we saw previously. Les conjugaisons irrégulières, and we'll focus on the verbs from the first group, and then, well, a specific category of verbs that will end with whether E, or then E accent aigu, and then une consonne, and then ER. So you've got a few examples here, so it could be ending with aider, aimer, aîner, été, but then many others as well, but then they will follow the rule that we will see here, okay? Because actually, even if they are regular, they will be affected and they will have slight changes. So I've been taking this amener, amener is to bring, okay? And then, so bring someone. And then we'll see that actually the tenses that will have these slight or little changes will be l'indicatif présent, le futur simple, le conditionnel présent, and then le subjonctif présent. It does mean that for all the other tenses, actually this verb amener will just behave like a normal verb from the first group, so it will follow the same rules of construction, okay? But then for indicatif présent, futur simple, conditionnel présent, and then subjonctif présent, little changes will happen, and that's exactly what we'll see in this video. So we'll start with le présent, and then it will go like j'amène, tu amènes, il amène, nous amenons, vous amenez, ils amènent. Okay, and then what can we see here? We can see that actually je, tu, il, and il will be concerned by this little change, and it's only the accent here, accent grave on the top of this e, okay? And then it will change, of course, the pronunciation, because you will have this e sound open. Amen, okay? Amen, tu amènes, il amène. Nous doesn't change. Nous amenons, okay? It's a silent her here, mute. Amenons. Vous amenez, exactly the same thing. You don't pronounce this e. And then here back, this change. So, amen. Okay? So, remember, the only thing that you will have to change or modify will be to put this accent, l'accent grave. Let's see now for the futur simple. J'amènerai. Tu amèneras, il amènera, nous amènerons, vous amènerez, ils amèneront. Okay, so we can see here that all the forms are concerned and all the forms are modified, but then the modification is exactly the same as we saw previously, so it's just this accent grave that you get to put on the top of this E. Amènerai, amènera, amènera, amèneront, amènerai, amèneront. Okay, let's see now for the conditionnel présent. J'amènerai, tu amènerais, il amènerait, nous amènerions, vous amèneriez, ils amèneraient. Okay, and it's exactly the same thing. So we'll have the modification, and this modification will affect all the forms, okay, but it will be exactly the same modification as we saw previously. Just put this accent grave on the top of this amènerait, 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 amènerions, amèneriez, amènerait. Okay, and let's see now the last one, le subjonctif présent, and it goes like que j'amène, que tu amènes, qu'il amène, que nous amenions, que vous ameniez, qu'ils amènent. Okay, and we can see that, well, we'll have the modification, but it will affect only je, tu, il, and then il at the plural form, and it will be exactly the same modification, this accent grave that we've got to put on the top of this e. Amen, amen, amen. Then for nous, you don't touch it, so amenions, vous ameniez, and then here, modification for il at the plural form, amen. Okay, and that's it. So remember that for this subgroup of verbs, so the one ending with e or then e accent aigu, and then une consonne, and then er, okay, so the following tenses will have this slight changes, so indicatif présent, futur simple, conditionnel présent, and then subjonctif présent. So for all the other tenses, no modifications, just put and just conjugate the verb as it should be conjugated according to the rule that will concern all the tenses. Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. This is Unité 15, leçon and in this lesson, we'll see together les mots exclamatifs and especially what we call les adjectifs exclamatifs. So, les adjectifs exclamatifs, well, actually, it won't be that difficult because we already know them, okay? We're talking about quel for the masculine singular form, then quel for the feminine singular form, and then for the plural form, so quel, and then plural form of the feminine, quel, like that. So the first thing, the good news is that if you listen carefully, quel, 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 okay, so phonetically you get only one form. Of course, when you've got this S, well, if you've got a vowel after, then you will have to make this liaison. But then, clearly, the basic form like that, phonetically, it's the same. Okay? We know them already because normally we use them when we ask questions. Okay? This what thing is quel in French. Okay? But then, of course, we've got to put the correct form according to the word it is connected to, so according to the gender, whether it's masculine or feminine, and then if it's singular or plural. Okay, and let's see how it will go. Sorry, you know, just before that, in most of the cases, and I insist on the most of the cases because we're not talking about all the cases, then when you will build this type of sentence, and we'll see that in few seconds. So the type of sentence that will include this mot exclamatif, so the one we saw, in most of the cases you won't use the verb. Okay, so let's see now a few examples. The first one, so with quel, okay, so this is the sentence that could illustrate quite well the use of quel. Quel beau vélo, okay, point d'exclamation. Well, you just want to say, what a beautiful bike. I mean, translation in English is exactly the same, okay? And then you can see that in this sentence, you don't need to put the verb after or then, I mean, in the sentence anyway. Quel beau vélo. Well, you could say, quel beau vélo. Tu as, for instance, you have, what a beautiful bike you have. But then in most of the cases, we don't need to put the verb, so we'll use this structure, quel beau vélo. And don't forget to put this point d'exclamation at the end, okay, because that's the whole concept about the thing, and we're talking about les mots exclamatifs, okay. Quel beau vélo tu as, okay, and then, well, feminine form, and then the singular, it could be, you could use this, quelle gentille serveuse. Okay, what a nice waitress. Quelle gentille serveuse. D'accord. When we're talking about the plural form, then it could be quels enfants sportifs. Okay, so you notice here that I've been making the liaison. So quels enfants sportifs. All right. And the last one for the feminine plural. Quelle fille intelligente. Okay, so quel beau vélo, quelle gentille serveuse, quels enfants sportifs, quelle fille intelligente. So you can see that it's actually quite easy to construct these structures and to use these mots exclamatifs. So if we're talking about les adjectifs exclamatifs here, quel, okay. And then don't forget to put le point d'exclamation at the end of your sentence. That's it for this lesson. If you want more videos, then youtube.com/imagier. And then I'm also on Facebook, so it's right here. And the website is waiting for you, www.imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Les mots exclamatifs, and especially les adverbes exclamatifs. Okay, so les adverbes exclamatifs, well, actually, they won't be that difficult because we will see in this lesson, the first one will be que, then the second one will be ce que, and the last one will be comme. Okay, so in that case, we're talking about exclamatif, so exclamation, so it does mean that, well, you could say to someone, tu es intelligent, you are intelligent, okay? But then, of course, if you want to insist, if you want to put this exclamation concept in that, well, first, you need to put this point d'exclamation at the end. And of course, normally, you will, if it's orally, you will tend to modify a little bit the sentence and the way you pronounce this sentence. So you will insist like, ah, oh, tu es intelligent. Okay, but then of course we've got these adverbs and then we can use them. It will be quite simple. The first one, actually, que, you just need to add it at the beginning of your sentence. Okay, so we've got exactly the same sentence as we had previously. So in the example, tu es intelligent, you just need to add this que, okay? Oh, que tu es intelligent. Okay, so in that case, well, sorry, I'm not a good actor, but then I try my best. But when you put this que in that case, well, you will insist on the fact that you are really, really surprised or amazed. Okay, que tu es intelligent. It will be exactly the same thing if you want to use this ce que. It's a bit more spoken, but still exactly the same way of construction. You just need to put ce que at the beginning, and you continue your sentence. Oh, ce que tu es intelligent. Okay, and the last one, well, comme. So, of course, it's another adverb, but then the meaning will be exactly the same. Comme tu es intelligent. Okay, so in all the three cases, the meaning is exactly the same. The adverbs will be different, but still, actually, you've got the choice. It's quite good. So you can say que tu es intelligent, ce que tu es intelligent, comme tu es intelligent. Okay. Les interjections, and especially the one that will express la satisfaction ou l'accord. So the first thing that we need to define actually is what is une interjection. Well, it's exactly the same in English. You know, all these little words that you can, in most of the cases, use on their own like that, or then you can combine them with a sentence, okay? And then by using these little words, you will express, well, shortly, your feelings, okay? So in that case, the thing that we would like to express is la satisfaction or l'accord, accord, so to agree, agreement, okay? And then the first option that we could have would be this bien, okay? Second one will be très bien. Third one could be bon. Okay, so bien, très bien, bon. Let's see more of them. Bravo would be an option as well. Bravo. Super. Génial. Okay, so bravo. Super, génial, cool, parfait, chouette, cool, parfait, chouette. And then actually it's quite interesting because lately we've been noticing that in French language people tend to use a lot this trop, hein, too much, okay? Trop fort, trop cool, trop bien. Okay? Trop fort, trop cool, trop bien. Les verbes et les prépositions, and it's the part number 5, numéro 5. But then first, we should definitely see some keywords together. The first one will be quelqu'un, because I will use these words quite often. So, and it means someone, somebody. And then quelque chose means something, quelque part, somewhere, someplace. Okay, so let's start right now. And the first verb is donner. Donner means to give. So, first structure that you can make is donner quelque chose, okay, without any preposition. Or then you can have this donner quelque chose à quelqu'un, okay? Or then donner quelque chose pour quelqu'un, or then pour quelque chose. All right, so one more time, donner quelque chose, donner quelque chose à quelqu'un, donner quelque chose pour quelqu'un ou pour quelque chose. Okay. Second verb, douter. D'accord. Douter. And then first structure, douter de quelqu'un or de quelque chose. Second structure, douter de plus. And then the verb should be at the infinitive form, infinitif. Or then the last structure, douter que. And then your verb should be at the subjonctive form. Okay, so one more time, douter. Douter de quelqu'un, douter de quelque chose, douter de plus verbe à l'infinitif, douter que plus verbe au subjonctif. Verbe suivant, le verbe échanger. Première structure, échanger quelque chose avec quelqu'un. Okay, so no preposition before the quelque chose. Échanger quelque chose avec quelqu'un. Or then, échanger quelque chose contre quelque chose. Okay, so two structures. The first one, échanger quelque chose avec quelqu'un. The second one, échanger quelque chose contre quelque chose. Okay? And then the next verb is écouter, so quite useful. First structure, écouter quelqu'un ou quelque chose, so no preposition before. Then, écouter quelqu'un plus verbe à l'infinitif. Okay. And the last one, écouter ce que plus verbe à l'indicatif. Okay. So one more time, écouter quelqu'un, écouter quelque chose, écouter quelqu'un plus verbe à l'infinitif. Or then, écouter ce que plus verbe à l'indicatif. The next verb is écrire. And écrire is quite important as well because it means to write. First structure, écrire quelque chose. So no preposition before. Écrire quelque chose. Then second structure, écrire quelque chose à quelqu'un. Okay. Or then écrire à quelqu'un de. And then the verb should be at the infinitive form, infinitif. And then écrire à quelqu'un que. And the verb should be at the indicatif. Okay, so one more time. Écrire quelque chose à quelqu'un, écrire à quelqu'un de plus verbe à l'infinitif. And then écrire à quelqu'un que plus verbe à l'indicatif. Okay. The next verb is embrasser. Embrasser means to kiss. And then first structure, embrasser quelqu'un, embrasser quelque chose. Okay, no preposition. Embrasser quelque chose à quelqu'un. Okay, so two structures, embrasser quelqu'un, embrasser quelque chose. And then embrasser quelque chose à quelqu'un. The next verb is emmener. Première structure, emmener quelqu'un, no preposition, then emmener quelqu'un quelque part, or then emmener quelqu'un and the verb should be at the infinitive form right after. Okay, so one more time. Emmener quelqu'un quelque part, ou emmener quelqu'un plus verbe à l'infinitif. Employer. Let's see how it goes. Employer quelqu'un, employer quelque chose. Okay, no preposition. Employer quelqu'un, or then quelque chose, à, and in that case, the verb should be at the infinitive form after. Okay, so one more time. Employer quelqu'un, employer quelque chose, employer quelqu'un ou quelque chose, à, and then the verb at the infinitive form. Emprunter. Emprunter, première structure, emprunter quelque chose, pas de préposition, emprunter quelque chose à quelqu'un. Ok, encore une fois, emprunter quelque chose à quelqu'un. Le verbe suivant, next verb is engager. Engager quelque chose. Ok, so no preposition before. Engager quelqu'un à, and then the verb should be at the infinitive form. And then, engager quelque chose dans quelque chose. Ok, so one more time. Engager quelque chose. Engager quelqu'un à, plus verbe à l'infinitif. Engager quelque chose dans quelque chose. Les verbes et les prépositions, and it's the part number 6. But then the first thing that we should to see together are the keywords that I will use in this lesson. And the first one is quelqu'un, and it means someone, somebody. Quelque chose, something. Quelque part, somewhere, or someplace. Okay, and we'll see the first verb, and the first verb is enseigner. Okay, so let's start now. Enseigner quelque chose, so without any preposition here. Enseigner quelque chose à quelqu'un. Okay, well, then you can use enseigner à, and then the verb that should be after, must be at the infinitive form. Okay, enseigner comment, same thing here, you should put the verb at the infinitive form. Okay, and the last one, enseigner que. And then the verb should be at the indicative form. Be careful, it's not because it's introduced by que that it should be at the subjunctive. Because in that case, your verb should be at the indicative. Okay, so let's see them one more time. Enseigner quelque chose à quelqu'un. Enseigner à, plus verbe à l'infinitif. Enseigner comment, plus verbe à l'infinitif. Enseigner que, plus verbe à l'indicatif. Verbe suivant, entendre. Entendre quelque chose. Pas de préposition. Entendre quelqu'un plus verbe à l'infinitif. Entendre quelqu'un ou quelque chose qui. And then the verb should be at the indicative form. Entendre que, okay, and in that case you've got two options, whether indicatif or conditionnel. And then the last one, entendre ce que plus indicatif. Okay, so one more time. Entendre quelqu'un, entendre quelque chose, entendre quelqu'un plus verbe à l'infinitif, entendre quelqu'un quelque chose. Qui plus verbe à l'indicatif. Entendre que plus verbe à l'indicatif ou verbe au conditionnel. Entendre ce que plus verbe à l'indicatif. Verbe suivant, entrer. Entrer quelque part. So in that case, you can use many prepositions. I just brought three of them, but then it could be à, en, dans, etc. And then, entrer quelque chose. Okay. Entrer quelque part, à, en, dans, etc. Entrer quelque chose. Verbe suivant, verbe envoyer. Envoyer. Première structure, envoyer quelqu'un, envoyer quelque chose. Pas de préposition. Envoyer quelqu'un ou quelque chose quelque part. Okay? Envoyer quelqu'un ou quelque chose à quelqu'un. Envoyer plus infinitif. And the last one, envoyer quelqu'un plus infinitif. OK, so let's see them one more time. Envoyer quelqu'un, envoyer quelque chose. Envoyer quelqu'un ou quelque chose quelque part. Envoyer quelqu'un ou quelque chose à quelqu'un. Envoyer plus verbe à l'infinitif. Envoyer quelqu'un plus verbe à l'infinitif. Verbe suivant, verbe espérer. Première structure, espérer quelque chose. Pas de préposition. Espérer plus infinitif. Espérer que plus indicatif. D'accord? Une fois. Encore une fois, sorry about that. Espérer quelque chose. Espérer plus infinitif. Espérer que plus indicatif. Verbe suivant, essayer. Première structure, essayer quelque chose. Pas de préposition ici. Deuxième structure, essayer de plus infinitif. Okay, so one more time. Essayer, essayer quelque chose. Essayer de plus infinitif. Verbe suivant, verbe excuser. Première structure, excuser quelqu'un, excuser quelque chose. Pas de préposition. Deuxième, excuser quelqu'un pour quelque chose. Troisième structure, excuser quelqu'un de quelque chose. Dernière structure, excuser de plus infinitif. OK, so, excuser, excuser quelqu'un, excuser quelque chose, excuser quelqu'un pour quelque chose, excuser quelqu'un de quelque chose, excuser de plus infinitif. Verbe suivant, verbe expliquer, expliquer, expliquer quelque chose, pas de préposition. Expliquer quelque chose à quelqu'un. Expliquer comment plus infinitif. Well, then it's also possible to use this. Expliquer comment plus verbe à l'indicatif. Expliquer ce que plus verbe à l'indicatif. Expliquer que plus verbe à l'indicatif, or it's also possible to use the subjunctive form, okay? If you've got a doubt here, whether you should use indicatif or subjunctif, I've been making some videos regarding the different of uses concerning indicatif and subjunctif, so you should definitely have a look at these videos. Okay? One more time. Expliquer quelque chose à quelqu'un, expliquer comment plus infinitif, expliquer comment plus indicatif, expliquer ce que plus indicatif, expliquer que plus indicatif ou subjonctif. Verbe suivant, verbe falloir. Falloir. Première structure, falloir quelque chose, so no preposition before. Deuxième structure, falloir quelque chose à quelqu'un. Troisième structure, falloir plus verbe à l'infinitif. Falloir quelque chose pour plus verbe à l'infinitif. And last but not least, falloir que plus verbe au subjonctif. Ok, one more time. Falloir quelque chose à quelqu'un, falloir plus infinitif, falloir quelque chose pour plus infinitif, falloir que plus subjonctif. Verbe suivant, verbe féliciter. Première structure, féliciter quelqu'un pour quelque chose. Deuxième structure, féliciter quelqu'un de quelque chose. Troisième structure, féliciter quelqu'un de plus verbe à l'infinitif. Ok, so one more time, féliciter. Féliciter quelqu'un pour quelque chose. Féliciter quelqu'un de quelque chose. Féliciter quelqu'un de plus verbe à l'infinitif. Les verbes et les prépositions, and it's the number 8. Okay, so but before starting, we should definitely see some keywords together because I will use them quite often in this video. The first one is quelqu'un, and it means someone or somebody. Then quelque chose, something, and then quelque part, somewhere or someplace. Okay, and we can start with the first verb, and it is fermer. Okay, so let's see now the structures we've got with fermer. And first one, la première, c'est fermer quelque chose. Okay, pas de préposition. Fermer quelque chose. Deuxième structure, fermer quelque chose à quelqu'un ou quelque chose. Okay, encore une fois, fermer quelque chose à quelqu'un ou quelque chose. Deuxième verbe, verbe finir. Verbe finir, première structure, finir quelque chose, pas de préposition, finir quelque chose plus un adverbe. Finir par quelque chose, finir avec quelque chose, finir par plus verbe à l'infinitif, finir de plus verbe à l'infinitif. Okay, so you can see many structures, so we'll see them one more time. Finir quelque chose plus un adverbe. Finir par quelque chose. Finir avec quelque chose. Finir par plus verbe à l'infinitif. Finir de plus verbe à l'infinitif. Verbe suivant, verbe fonder. Fonder. Regardons les structures ensemble. Fonder quelque chose, pas de préposition. Fonder quelque chose sur quelqu'un ou quelque chose. Ok, so one more time, encore une fois. Fonder quelque chose sur quelqu'un ou quelque chose. Verbe suivant, verbe forcer. Forcer. Première structure, forcer quelque chose, pas de préposition. Forcer quelqu'un à plus verbe à l'infinitif. Ok, encore une fois, forcer quelqu'un à quelque chose, forcer quelqu'un à plus verbe à l'infinitif. Verbe suivant, verbe gagner. Gagner, trois structures. Première structure, gagner quelque chose. Pas de préposition, gagner quelque chose, gagner en quelque chose. Troisième structure, gagner à plus verbe à l'infinitif. Gagner en quelque chose, gagner à plus verbe à l'infinitif. Verbe suivant, verbe garder. Garder, trois structures, garder quelque chose. Pas de préposition. Garder quelque chose de quelqu'un. Garder quelque chose à quelqu'un. D'accord? Garder quelque chose de quelqu'un. Garder quelque chose à quelqu'un. Verbe suivant, verbe grandir. Grandir, trois structures possibles. Grandir quelqu'un, pas de préposition. Grandir de quelque chose. Grandir de plus verbe à l'infinitif. D'accord? Trois structures. La première, grandir quelqu'un, grandir de quelque chose, pour la deuxième, grandir de plus verbe à l'infinitif, pour la troisième. Verbe suivant, verbe grossir. Grossir, grossir quelqu'un ou grossir quelque chose. Grossir de quelque chose. Donc grossir quelqu'un, grossir quelque chose, grossir de quelque chose. Verbe suivant, verbe habiller. Habiller, habiller quelqu'un, habiller quelque chose. Habiller quelqu'un en quelqu'un ou quelque chose. D'accord? Habiller quelqu'un, habiller quelque chose, habiller quelqu'un en quelqu'un ou quelque chose. Verbe hésiter, hésiter, hésiter entre quelqu'un, quelque chose et quelqu'un ou quelque chose. OK? Hésiter dans quelque chose, hésiter sur quelque chose, et le dernier, hésiter à plus verbe à l'infinitif. D'accord? Donc encore une fois, hésiter entre quelqu'un, quelque chose, et quelqu'un ou quelque chose, hésiter dans quelque chose, hésiter sur quelque chose, hésiter à plus verbe à l'infinitif. Les verbes et les prépositions, et c'est le numéro 9. But then before starting, we should definitely see some keywords together because I will use them quite often in this video. So, quelqu'un, quelque chose, quelque part. OK? Quelqu'un, quelque chose, quelque part. Et le premier verbe est le verbe ignorer. Ignorer. Ignorer quelqu'un, ignorer quelque chose. Pas de préposition. Ignorer que plus verbe à l'indicatif. Ignorer si plus verbe à l'indicatif. D'accord? Ignorer quelqu'un, ignorer quelque chose, ignorer que plus verbe à l'indicatif, ignorer si plus verbe à l'indicatif. Imaginez. Imaginez quelqu'un, imaginez quelque chose. Pas de préposition. Imaginez quelqu'un plus infinitif. Imaginez plus infinitif. Imaginez que plus verbe à l'indicatif. D'accord? Imaginez quelqu'un, imaginez quelque chose. Imaginez quelqu'un plus infinitif. Imaginez plus infinitif. Imaginez que plus indicatif. Verbe suivant, imposer. Imposer quelqu'un, imposer quelque chose. Pas de préposition. Imposer quelqu'un, quelque chose à quelqu'un, quelque chose. Imposer à quelqu'un de plus infinitif. Imposer que plus subjonctif. Donc imposer quelqu'un, imposer quelque chose. Imposer quelqu'un ou quelque chose à quelqu'un ou quelque chose. Imposer à quelqu'un de plus infinitif. Imposer que plus subjonctif. Verbe suivant, indiquer. Indiquer quelque chose à quelqu'un. Indiquer que plus indicatif. Indiquer comment plus infinitif. Indiquer quelque chose à quelqu'un. Indiquer que plus indicatif. Indiquer comment plus infinitif. Verbe suivant, interdire. Interdire quelque chose à quelqu'un. Interdire de plus infinitif. D'accord? Interdire quelque chose à quelqu'un, interdire de plus infinitif. Introduire. Oops, should be introduce here. Say is missing. Introduire quelque chose dans quelque chose. Introduire quelqu'un auprès de quelqu'un. D'accord? Introduire quelque chose dans quelque chose. Introduire quelqu'un auprès de quelqu'un. Inviter quelqu'un quelque part. Inviter quelqu'un à plus infinitif. Inviter à quelque chose. D'accord? Inviter quelqu'un quelque part. Inviter quelqu'un à plus infinitif. Inviter à quelque chose. Jeter quelqu'un dehors. Jeter quelque chose quelque part. Jeter quelque chose quelque part. Verbe jouer. Jouer avec quelqu'un ou quelque chose. Jouer à quelque chose. Jouer de quelque chose. Jouer quelque chose, jouer avec quelqu'un ou quelque chose. Jouer à quelque chose, jouer de quelque chose. Laisser quelque chose. Laisser quelqu'un ou quelque chose quelque part. Laisser quelqu'un ou quelque chose plus infinitif. Laisser quelqu'un quelque chose à quelqu'un. Laisser à plus infinitif. Encore une fois, laisser quelque chose. Laisser quelqu'un ou quelque chose quelque part. Laisser quelqu'un ou quelque chose plus infinitif. Laisser quelqu'un ou quelque chose à quelqu'un. Ou laisser à plus infinitif. Les adjectifs, et plus précisément l'adjectif épithète. Okay, so let's see now what it means, because this is the first question, what is l'adjectif épithète? Well, you will see that it's quite simple, because it is an adjective, so an adjectif associé à un nom. Okay, so you will associate this adjective to a noun, all right? So we've got the example here, une femme célèbre. Okay, so if you take the time to look, you've got une femme, a woman, and after that you've got this célèbre. Okay, so it's an adjective, and you can see that it's directly connected to une femme. So this is what we call an adjective épithète. Okay, and the translation is here. So let's see a few examples now. Un animal domestique. So same thing here, you've got domestic right after your noun. Un grand appartement. So it's quite interesting because you've got here grand, so the adjective before the noun. And then the last example, un nouveau livre. Same thing here, you get nouveau before your noun. Okay, and for the translations? So, it's actually quite interesting because we've been noticing that when we talk about l'adjectif épithète, we will have two situations. The first one will be antéposé, so it means that this adjective will come before the noun, Okay, avant le nom. Well, then, the second option, it's actually when the adjective is coming after the noun, so it's postposé, so après le nom. Okay, so whether anteposé or then postposé, before the noun, after the noun. Okay, so let's see now few examples when it's anteposé. And the first one, un bon ami. Okay, so we can see that here you've got this adjective, bon. Okay, and then you pronounce it bon ami when you make this link. Second example, une belle femme. So same thing here, you've got this adjective, belle, okay, the feminine form because you've got une femme, but then it's coming before femme. And for the translations, and then we saw that it could come also after, so it will be postposé, okay, and in that case, we've got a simple example here, un travail difficile. Okay, so you get difficile, and difficile is coming after travail, okay, but it's directly coming, so you get nothing between the two. And then, une expérience enrichissante, same thing here, the adjective is coming right after the noun, and of course you get the feminine form here, because une expérience is feminine. And for the translations, l'adjectif attribut. Okay, so we saw in the previous video l'adjectif épithète, and then we'll continue with l'adjectif attribut in this video. Okay, so the question is, what is l'adjectif attribut? Well, l'adjectif attribut, well, clearly it's an adjective, of course, and it will appear or it will be in or dans un groupe verbal. So it means that you will need to have at least one verb that will somehow introduce this adjective. Okay, so in most of the cases you will see this adjective introduced by être, to be. Okay, but then it could be other verbs as well, but then keep in mind that être is quite often used. Okay, so let's see now a few examples. The first one, le canapé est confortable. So you can see that in this structure you get here the subject, le canapé, then you get the verb est, and then you get this adjective. So adjective, this adjective is introduced by être, so est here, so it does mean that it's an adjective attribut. Okay, le canapé est confortable. La vue est magnifique. La vue est magnifique. So exactly the same situation here. You've got la vue, then you've got the verb être, and after that you've got your adjective here. Les enfants sont calmes. Okay, same thing here. You've got les enfants, then you've got the verb être, and the adjective is coming after. So you can see, you cannot see here the feminine form, because it's actually the same form as the masculine, but keep in mind that you should put the feminine because it's an adjective, and then if this adjective will changes when you put the feminine, then you should definitely put the feminine form here when you get the feminine. Here you get the plural form, so basically you just put this S at the end. Okay, so for the translations, here they come. Let's take few examples again. So, le directeur est autoritaire. La voiture est bleue. Okay, so in that case it's quite interesting because you can see that normally we get the, well, the adjective bleu. So it's B-L-E-U for the masculine form, or the basic form if you want. And then in that case we've got la voiture, so it's feminine, so you should put this at the end, okay? Phonetically it doesn't exist because you don't pronounce it, so you get bleu, as you would get for the masculine form, okay? But still, you need to write it here because it's the feminine form. La voiture est bleue. And then, les légumes sont délicieux, okay? Les légumes sont délicieux. So in all these cases, autoritaire, bleu and then délicieux, well, these adjectives, les adjectifs, are what we can call adjectifs, attributs. Let's see the translations now. Il devient nerveux. So in that case, it's quite interesting because you can see that I didn't put être, but then I did put this devenir, to become. Okay? Il devient nerveux. Elle reste calme. Elle reste calme. Ça semble difficile. Ça semble difficile. Okay, so in these cases, even if we don't have être, so as I said in the introduction, so we've got other verbs, devenir, to become, rester, to stay, and then sembler, to seem. Okay, so in these cases also, you will introduce some adjectives after, and these adjectives will be what we call adjectif attribut. Okay, so let's see now the translations. Something that you should remember. So, attribut, so this adjective attribut, can be attribut du sujet, like we have been seeing so far. So, ce film est bon. Okay, so in that case, you've got the subject, ce film, and then you've got the verb, and after that, you've got this adjective. Okay, but keep in mind that it's also possible to have this attribut as attribut de l'objet, okay? So it does mean that, well, still you've got a sentence, you've got a verb, okay? But then the adjective will not be related or connected to the subject, okay? But it will be connected to this object. So when we call the object, it's the grammatical object, okay? So, je trouve ce film bon. Well, in that case, also this bon will be adjectif attribut. Translation, so ce film est bon, and then je trouve ce film bon.